In this video, I am going to explain biomechanics of high arch and flat arch of the foot. You know, our feet has the curve naturally. So as we have the arches, we can sustain our body weight. But when people have too much curve, this is high arch, or very little arch, that makes problem for foot, ankle, or even the whole body. That's why adequate arch is essential for adequate movement and posture. So what is high arch? What makes high arch? The high arch is called the supinated foot. Supinated foot, which is the supination of the foot. On the other hand, the flat arch, this movement is the pronation of the foot. You know, supination and pronation of the foot is very, very complicated. If I think about the supination and pronation of the hand, it's easy. The one movement, one joint movement. However, the supination and pronation of the foot are the combination of many movement. So before I jump into the supination and pronation of the foot, I have to explain each movement of ankle joint. The first movement is this one, dorsiflexion. Dorsiflexion. And this is plantar flexion. Dorsiflexion and plantar flexion. Two movements. So four more movements. And this is inversion of the foot. This is eversion of the foot. Inversion and eversion. You know, inversion and supination look very similar, and eversion and pronation look very similar, but they are different. The inversion is just a single movement of the foot. As well, eversion is a single movement of the foot. Supination and pronation are combination of the movement. Okay? This is inversion. This is eversion. And two more movements. This is abduction of the foot. Abduction, open up feet. And this is adduction of the foot. I do it with my hands. This is abduction of the foot. And this is adduction of the foot. Abduction and adduction. Okay, six movements you have to know. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion, inversion and eversion, abduction and adduction. So now you know six movements of ankle joint. So let's jump into what supination is. What kind of movement do you have to know to understand supination? Okay, supination is combination of three movements, which are plantar flexion plus inversion plus adduction. I will say that again. Supination is combination of plantar flexion plus inversion plus adduction. That looks very complicated movement, isn't it? Again, supination is plantar flexion plus inversion plus adduction. Okay? So let's jump into pronation. Pronation is opposite to supination. So combination of dorsiflexion plus eversion plus abduction of the foot. I will say that again. The pronation is combination of dorsiflexion plus eversion plus abduction. So pronation is kind of a flat arch, and supination is kind of high arch. You know, this is very complicated. So review of today's video. Dorsiflexion, plantar flexion, inversion, eversion, abduction, adduction. Supination is combination of plantar flexion plus inversion plus adduction. Okay, this is high arch. Okay, so pronation is opposite. Pronation is combination of dorsiflexion, eversion, plus abduction. The pronation is kind of a flat arch. But you know, as you understand and study the mechanics of arches, this is not just a simple mechanics. If you go deep, supination and high arch is different. But I just want to be very simple in this video. So in this video, you can say, oh, okay, supination is high arch, pronation is flat arch. But if you have to solve the quiz or exam, please follow your textbook or your teacher. I'm just simplifying the mechanics of anatomy today. So I hope this video helps your understanding of what is high arch, the supination, and what is flat arch. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.